In this problem, we have to find the derivative of this function. So to do that, we want to write this as x to a power. So the very first step is to do that. So we have f of x, and that's equal to, so the trick is to realize there is a number here, so 1. So it's always going to be this number over this number, always. So in this case, it's just x to the 1 over 3. Every single time, just this number over this number. Okay, so now we can use the power rule for derivatives. So using the power rule, f prime of x, the symbol is prime, it means we're taking the derivative, is equal to. So you take the 1/3 and you put it in the front. So 1 over 3, then you have your x. And then you subtract 1 from the exponent, right? There's a 1/3 here. So you would do 1/3, usually you do it mentally, but I'll show the work. 1/3 minus 1, and so that's really 1/3 minus 3/3. So now we can subtract them. So 1 minus 3 is negative 2, so you get negative 2/3. So you get negative 2/3. And that's actually it. That is the answer, right? That's all you have to do. So you put the number in the front and then subtract 1. And if you need to do the subtraction, you typically do it on the side. It's usually a bad idea to do it like in the problem. It creates a lot of clutter. So, you know, you just go to the side and do the math and you get negative 2/3. And then you write it in over here. What is the derivative? It's the slope of the tangent line to the graph of this function. Or loosely speaking, it's just the slope of the function. So this is the slope of the function. I hope this video has been helpful. Good luck.